So, we are back in the old space station, and we are going to hopefully give the old modified Logitech Brio a go at imaging the moon. So, there it is. I've stuck some heat sinks to the back. I'm hoping that that might help with the noise. It probably won't. But we'll give it a go. I won't be live streaming because for some reason with a 15-foot USB lead, that's USB 3, we can only get 1080p. But we want 4K. So let's go connect it to a laptop that has USB 3 back down on Earth. And we shall see if we can actually get it to get some shots of the moon. So I'm just zooming around the moon with the Brio, and it's a Celestron Sky Prodigy 90, which is 1250mm. I think it's like F15 or F14, something like that. I can't remember without looking it up, which I'm not going to do. You could do that yourself. So I just thought I'd give you, a couple of sample clips that I've just zoomed around the moon. Well, not zoomed, because I haven't got a zoom, but... anyway, so enjoy those. So, I thought I should probably tell you that I'm just using Windows 10's built-in camera app for the video. I'm recording it at 4K 30 frames a second. And I'm going to stick in some still shots just straight out of the webcam and the telescope. And I am going to, hopefully, if it works and it makes it into the video... some shots that I'm going to stack in Registacks and see what happens. So you might see those, you might not, it depends if they work or not. Because it's a bit, the atmospheres are not very great tonight, but anyway. Right, so these photos that you're going to see now are just straight from Windows camera app that I'm on a 2 second timer and stuck them in. And they're right ish. Right, so the next bit is where I've stacked it in Registax 6. I stabilised the video, which is about 12 seconds in pip. It was about 300 and something frames, and I think I dropped every 2 frames. So, and then stacked 80% of the best frames in Registax, and to be honest, it didn't come out too brilliant. Right, well, I hope you enjoyed that and it's inspired you to go spend a stupid amount of money on a webcam. Windows 10's camera app isn't the best because you haven't got very much control over things. You can only really adjust the exposure on it, I can find. But probably get better results using SharpCap or a proper dedicated camera app. So if I ever get it to live stream or record from OBS Studio in 4K, I've got much more control on that, so I'll give that a go at some point when I get a decent USB lead. Anyway, thanks for watching, like, thumbs up, subscribe, share it with your friends if you have any, and I will bid you bon nuit.